And welcome back to Let's Play Mass Effect 3 Blind. I'm the RPG chick, as always. Before we go to our next destination, I know I said in a comment, I'm not sure if I said it later in the beginning of one of these videos or not. By the way, we are leaving Grissom Academy. I have a note on that as well. Just a quick little thing, reminder, I'm not reading comments until I finish the game. You guys are encouraged to leave comments, and I will read them all and answer them when I am done with the game, which would probably be a week or so before the last, episode is up. So when I start answering comments left and right, you guys know I've finished. But anyway, as for that, reminder, don't post private messages, messages on other videos. Trying to get around this so that I'll see it. The whole purpose of me not reading comments on these videos is to prevent spoilers and such, and I will not read your comment, and I may just block you so that you'll stop. So, don't do it. I don't want you to do it. I'm not kidding around here. All that kind of stuff. I had a friend, I asked him to look at my videos to see if, you know, there were negative comments, this and that, and nothing really that, I was really looking for troll comments and stuff, just to see what the hell was going on, and, yeah, some people were upset about the fact that they thought I didn't notice something with the weight limit. I did. I just happened to not say anything at the time and decided to work with the weight limit and see how things went with that. Seems to be pretty okay. I mean, the cooldown time for everything seems to be a little longer than the first game, or the second game rather, but not by much. So I'm working with it. I know it's like plus 200 or something like that, and you know, some people are like, well, how could you not notice that? It's right in the middle of the screen. How could you play like that? It seems to be working fine for me, and if I, you know, have a problem with it, I'll adjust it. But I just went through what I've been told by a real life friend might be the hardest mission in the game. He's like, oh my god, you did the Grissom Academy with where you meet Jack and everything like that. He said it's pretty tough, you know, and he's someone I can trust. I know him in real life, and he, you know, basically told him after I finished the mission, and he's like, yeah, from when you started the game, that might be the hardest mission in the game. That's why I call that video the hardest mission in the game, question mark. Not so much like at all, but because I did this mission so early on. Later on, all he said is that with the progression of your skills and such, and your squad mate skills, that this mission will not be as tough. But just the way that they surround you and from all sides and stuff like that, it's crazy. I can't even imagine what it must be like on like the hardest difficulty, like Nightmare or whatever difficulty, whatever they're calling it. I can't imagine. So I think I died 2 or 3 times, but I managed to finish it, and that's with the weight limit. So think of it as, you know, I'm just getting a feel for the game right now. Maybe an extra challenge for me. And yeah, that's it. I'm still figuring things out. I'm still looking into things. I haven't gone through the little, you know, what was it? Sorry, I'm just gonna come out of this and the manual. I haven't even read any of this. So I probably should. So where are we going now? So anyway, yeah, some people are like, you know, I don't know, concerned or pissed off about that, I don't know. There were like about 3 people, so... Yeah, it's just me playing it the way I want to play it, and... Oh, there's no other systems, okay. So we're done with this whole... I guess... cluster? The entire Petra Nebula, okay. Only consists of the Petus system, I think it said. Oh, look at it, says 60%. There is a percentage. It just doesn't say it when you're there. Yeah, interesting. So, we've got the Citadel, which I'm really looking forward to getting back to. We've got the Diplomats, which is the main quest. We've got these two areas that we don't have any quests in so far, as well as Minos and Shrike Abyssal. As far as I know, no quests there. It's at least not indicating here. We've got this mystery Cerberus lab hanging out over here. What if we just go... Look at that. What's here? Look at that. There's something... Something's gonna be there, isn't there? That's a system that's gonna be there at some point. Because not only is it bounce off, but... It's almost like I can select it there. And it comes from where? All the way... This way? See, that's connected there, that's connected there. This is all connected. Minos. That's connected to here. So I can see where these systems are going to appear. We just can't go there yet. It's really interesting. Anyway. But we can still bounce off them, which is funny. All right, let's go. Let's check out the Cerberus lab. I don't want to race through the main storyline. It doesn't make sense for us to go here first. I mean, we should really convene with the council as soon as possible. But if I did everything, you know, in a realistic fashion, like how I would do it if I existed in this universe, we'd really just do the main quest and that's it. I mean, maybe one or two things and that would be it. So we've got... Okay. We've got the Sepsis. Sepsis! Mmm! And a Decoris system. And apparently, yeah, just these two. And this is a Reaper inhabited system. There was a Reaper presence here. Look, there's a little moon there. So when I scan, they'll get closer. By the way, I do have to go back to a system which I noted here. The Castellus system. I have to look for more assets. I was interrupted before I really satisfied myself with that. So in case anyone's worried about the Castellus system, if there's something there, I'm going back, don't worry. I'll go back. Just not in this episode. Right, Wallace Darwin. I remember this system from Mass Effect 2. An unusually small Pegasid, or hot Jupiter, Wallis was originally an extrasolar planet that entered this system and was captured by the gravity well of the G-class star Sepsis. Tidally locked, Wallis's hot side reaches temperatures over 2,500 degrees Celsius. While not large enough proportionate to the star to... That's a really awkward sentence. To the star to cause... eclipses as visible from Watson, it is easily seen at dawn or dusk as one of the brightest objects in the sky. One day length is equal to 11 Earth days. Still so funny how you don't scan planets individually. I'm getting used to that whole mechanic. Darwin! a mid-sized rock planet, Darwin is ironically named being one of the worst places for life in the galaxy. Its atmosphere is punishing, its temperature boiling, its chemical makeup toxic. Carbon monoxide and methane wrap the planet in an unyielding haze, and scans of its surface show only silicates and molten tin. Its daily thermal fluctuations lead to hurricane-level vortices, two at each pole forming eyes that can be seen from orbit. Despite all this, Darwin is still used by spacers as a drive core discharge point. Hydrogen pierces the clouds in the upper atmosphere, making for a relatively benign approach. Franklin, right? And Watson. Elementary, my dear Watson. Watson is known in human media for two things: its spectacular tides brought on by a large moon, and the bureaucratic snafu over which Earth nations got to settle there first. Watson is a garden world first discovered in 2165 CE, with credit claimed by the Chinese People's Federation, the United North American States, and the European Union. The system's alliance brokered the infamous Reykjavik Compromise, allowing limited colonization from each coalition in cities comprised of populations from each nation. Watson itself trends cooler than Earth, with the temperate zone measuring about 30 degrees latitude in either direction from the equator. Its life does not easily map to Earth's evolutionary eras. Some islands have species that resemble terrestrial placental mammals. Others are overrun by arthropods. It is estimated that at least two more generations of xenozoologists will be needed to properly classify all the species of the planet. Okay. And its moon, Dr. Franklin. A large moon, Franklin retains a trace atmosphere of carbon dioxide, but its desolate surface holds no signs of water or life. In order to defend Watson from the pirates of the Terminus systems, Franklin is home to two Alliance spaceports and naval bases capable of fielding six fighter squadrons each and a classified number of interplanetary ballistic missiles. Mass effect fields keep the gravity in its installations at a comfortable level for long-term living. Okay. Next is Crick. Known for its spectacular geysers that can be seen from orbit, Crick is a rock planet with expansive frozen oceans. Though it is within the temperature and pressure range for human habitation, its thick atmosphere is largely carbon dioxide and monoxide, making breath masks or environmental suits mandatory. The most abundant resources for exploitation are the potassium salts found in its seabeds, which fetch good prices on terraforming worlds. Stuff. Okay, I've got a gas giant here. Pauling. A hydrogen methane gas giant, Pauling's gravitational field is believed to have cleared most of what would otherwise have been a sizable asteroid belt. The 2163 mission of the space probe Ultimate gave the inhabitants of Watson reams of data reinforcing this theory, giving the colonists an accurate count of its moons, 66, rings, moon-like ring objects, and more than 200 impact craters on the surface of its metallic core. Ultimate has been since retrieved for reuse on subsequent missions within the solar system. Now, I just want to make sure I didn't miss anything. We went here, right? Crick, yeah. So I got Crick and then that. Okay. Finally, Kamowitz. Named for the 21st century pioneer of groundwater remediation techniques, Kamowitz is an impressive layer of ice over a stony metallic core. Despite its size, it has only one moon, Noah, which shares its carbonaceous composition, leading astronomers to believe it formed following a giant impact. Iridium deposits have attracted miners to the planet, who must work through robots and telepresence because of the planet's strong gravity. Alright, so that's this entire system. So shall we scan for stuff? Okay, so they would come from there and there. Just wonder.
I found something.
Cool. What'd you find? Launch. Probe away. Lost and found. Ooh. Javelin missile launchers. I like that theme that comes up. So that's it, huh? So we got a war asset for javelin missile launchers. Cool. ...50% assets recovered. You know, I don't remember seeing that. So that means there's one more asset. Ooh. Did you hear that? I heard something as I was traveling through. Not hearing it now. Hmm. Where else would this crap be? One more? Can I investigate? Units of fuel. Ah!
Faster than light jump successful.
Oh my god. So 50% assets recovered from this entire system. You know, I don't remember seeing that from the other system. Sorry guys, maybe that I did not see. So some things I don't see, some things I see, but I don't say anything. I'm gonna try to, you know, vocalize what I'm thinking a little bit more. Sometimes I get so caught up in the thought process of like, well, yeah, it looks like there's weight, and well, let's see how it goes, and I get so wrapped up in thinking that I don't even say it. It's just, you know, I don't vocalize it. Whether you guys believe me or not, that's the truth. So in the Decoris system, here's Sanctum, and here's Lena. Let's look at this, Lena. Lena, or Cloaked, is a methane-clouded hothouse planet. Its lack of a metal-rich core and significant magnetosphere allows for an easy scan, which reveals mining equipment on its surface. It can be deduced that this mining occurred within the last 5 years. Any longer and the machines would have been worn down to nothing by the excessive heat and dust storms of hot iron oxide. Gravity is identical to that of Earth. Temperature most certainly is not. Now, we're talking about scanning. Can I just scan here?
Signal confirmed.
Cool. And I don't see any note of Reaper presence or awareness. What you got? Lost and found. Credits salvage recovered. Salvage credits recovered. Alright. Now always check, because I don't know if there's ever going to be one, more than like two things on one planet. 50% assets recovered from Decoris as well. Sanctum is proof of the old spacer adage. Just because it's a garden world doesn't mean it's a picnic. Freezing ice storms cover the poles and temperate zones, leaving a narrow strip of habitable land at the equator. Dry but windy, this area is home to Sanctum's minimal terrestrial plant life. The planet has yet to develop land-based animals, though invertebrates grow quite large in its pelagic seas. Mining, referred to as ice cracking at anywhere but the equator, is a common employment on Sanctum. The planet is rich in platinum and palladium deposits, as well as boron, which is locally used in semiconductor doping. Travel advisory. Carbon dioxide levels on Sanctum can reach 5,000 parts per million during thermal inversions. Travelers should carry a breath mask at all times and consult the Sanctum World Weather Service for warnings. Travel advisory. Piracy is at a 14-year global high on Sanctum. Visitors should take appropriate security precautions. Colony was founded in 2169, population 257,300. Capital is Vulpes, or whatever the hell. Now, I'm thinking there's something else to be found here. Something here. Okay, so we got 350 units of fuel, which is good. Assets recovered. Sigurd's Cradle. Okay, so we've got all the assets. Good to know. Still, I won't forget to go back and check that other one. Look at the percentage and all that stuff and scan the, you know. I think that was my first scan or my second scan. Okay, so let's go down to Sanctum. Cool. My squad of badasses awaits. Garrison Liara will do. I saw this the first time, guys. I saw it all along, so. I don't see it as that bad. I'm gonna try not to increase it. And if I can decrease it, all the better. Hoping as I find more advanced weapons, they'll be, you know, lighter in weight. This is the killer right here. This one and these two. I mean, I pretty much set up all their stuff already. Okay, I got points. Look at this. Weight capacity or squad meat damage. That's a very specific event here. or decrease shield recharge delay. Ammo capacity or headshot damage? I'd choose ammo capacity for that. Recharge speed or suspend. Yeah, I like that. Let's do that this time. Shockwave mastery already. It's only what, my third mission? Garrus. Yeah, I can increase. Hit one additional target within 8 meters. Or increase damage. It's for overload. Concussive shot. Frozen target. Or recharge speed. Health and armor damage. Squad mates gain ammo power. At half effectiveness. Proximity mine, which I've hardly put anything in. I could increase recharge speed. And well, I won't have enough to get the next one. Turian Reb, I don't have enough for that. At least 6, I think, yeah. I'm going to overload. I'm going to increase damage. I'm going to pretty much keep it as a single, you know, single attack, at least for now. And I've never used overload in any other way, so I just feel like keeping it like that. Singularity. Singularity is freaking awesome. ...25% damage to lifted targets. Or increase recharge speed. Stasis is a good crowd control thing. I never really used it in any of the games. So that's why I'm like not increasing that. Warp ammo. Or warp. Warp. Damage and duration. Weapon damage taken by a target. Power damage taken by a target. And pure biotic. Of course, it's going to be either weapon damage or health. Or actually, power, force, and duration. Health is in here somewhere, isn't it? Or is it back here? Health. Yeah, this stuff. Weapon damage, power, force, and duration. I'm probably going to end up taking power, force, and duration, but... I don't know. I mean, when I take that. For now... Sorry, guys. I know it's like we're not even starting this mission, this episode, because I'm gonna end up cutting it, because we're about a half hour in. Weapon damage, power damage, damage duration. Let's do singularity. Lifted targets. There you go. Confirm.
Commander, I've got a hail from Admiral Hackett.
Oh, good.
Put him through, Lieutenant.
Shepard, we've uncovered a secret Cerberus lab, function unknown.
I know, we're headed there.
We sent in a recon team, but they were forced to pull out before they got very far.
Oops, sorry.
Any other intel?
We think they're using the facility to warehouse and study Reaper tech.
We've been
wondering how Cerberus is connected to the Reapers, and this might give us some answers.
We're on it.
Find out what Cerberus is doing and get me any Reaper tech samples you can, Commander. Hackett